Welcome back, Blade fans. And yeah, so Vivi has been working overtime, turning out new models. This one I've been waiting for since I heard about it first time over a month ago. Here we are in December already. And this is the Cogent. And the Cogent is a button lock. This one happens to be in jade green G10. And I looked up the meaning of the word cogent, and it is clear, logical, and convincing. So, a lot of aspirations for this blade. Clear, logical, and convincing. Cogent. Being cogent. Kind of a cool name for a knife. And you may recognize the profile as being very similar to the Relic. They changed the handle a little bit, put a little finger swell in there, a little grip, put some machining marks or milling on the handle, and pretty much the same blade with the jimping on the back and great action. So now I'm going to have you seeing double, because I like this so much I got two. And what do we have but a Damascus version? I am told that Civivi's Damascus is 9CR18 MOV, which is a pretty good steel. If you know any different, let me know in the comments. We're going to measure these guys up in just a moment, and I want to give you a good look at this one, which is in green micarta, whereas the other is in natural jade G10. One thing I noticed on this one was a little stiff. Adjusted the pivot on it, and opens and closes just fine. A little bit of lock stick. And I'm going to let you hear that. So if you heard that little click, it's probably going to work in, but not present on this model. Completely smooth on that button. What happens with the button locks is sometimes the tolerances and maybe lack of oil give it that little bit of crunch when you first give it a push. It doesn't really bother me, except paid a little bit more for the Damascus version than for the JG10 one. But let's use the prettier of the two, if you consider that the Damascus is prettier, handsomer, whatever. But let's do the measurements on that one. Got an overall length of 8 7/8. Call it like, did I say 8 7/8? I meant to say 7 7/8. We're going to call it a 7.8 inch overall. I'm going to call the blade pretty close to 3.5 with a cutting edge. A little less than that, maybe like 3.3 to 3.4. I suppose I could read their specs right off the sheet, but what the heck. It's entertaining to do it this way, right? Handle thickness. We're going to call that pretty close to half an inch, 0.51. And the blade stock, a little on the thin side, but Civivis are known for that. Thin and slicey, 2.8 millimeters. And finally, a weight. And we're going to assume that the weight is comparable on both models. So let's weigh this one. Wait for that scale to zero out. It doesn't seem to want to do that. Let's try it again. There we go. So we got a very light 3.41 ounces. 3.4 ounces. Nice. So for roughly a 3.5-inch blade and a sub-8-inch package overall, we have a comfortable ergonomic knife. Very flat, deep carry clip, and although the clip is not recessed on this one, the screws are. So certainly having the screws recessed is a big advantage, even more so than having the clip recessed. And yes, as with most Civivis these days, it does switch to the left side. You are lucky left-handers. Nice detail work on the handle. We've got kind of a fuller going down the middle. We've got some cross hatches here. We've got holes that go straight through. Kind of interesting for Civivi. I don't see too many like that. Maybe you know of some. This is a hand-rubbed, etched Damascus blade, so they advertise. It's a clip point. I'd almost call it a Bowie. Definitely a clip point with a little swedge at the top. They've maintained the thickness pretty well out to the tip. Maybe we can see that a little bit better on the other one. I'm not sure. They're both sort of black blades. Here we go. Now the steel on this one is 18C28N Sandvik. I thought they were going to do 3V or V3? 3V. Or is it Nitro V? Nitro V. Sorry about that. I thought they were going to do Nitro V on this one, but it is not marked. But it's supposed to be Sandvik, according to the specs that I got from White Mountain Knives. By the way, White Mountain Knives does have these in stock as of this moment. Might be a few that aren't in stock. And to prove it, add to cart means they're in stock. That is... Oh, that's the relic. Well, shame on me. Let's look up the Cogent. Okay, so the Cogent is out of stock in the purple handle, the black blade. This one that I have is also currently out of stock, and it was $69.50, less 10%. Looks like that one's out of stock already. I'm not too encouraging here, am I? And, we got one in stock. We have a serrated with a burgundy handle. Looks like a burgundy micarta with a black blade serrated. And we do have the serrated natural JG10 with a black handle. I'm not going to go through them all, but there's your prices. So they're coming in right around the $70 mark, unless you are going to want this guy, which is $97.75 because it's Damascus, of course, and it's got a micarta handle. So don't forget Old Sword for your coupon code. Gets you 10% off, and every little bit helps. Great action, so let's talk a little bit about that. Nice knife, good size handle for a medium size folder. Nice to see more button locks. And we got a flipper tab that's very muted. Very short, but nicely jimped on both sides of it. And you can fail it. Then again, that's not too hard on button locks. But just a little bit more, and you should have no problems whatsoever. However, you can use the old gravity knife method as well. And speaking of that, this may or may not be something that is legal in your area, but that's up to you guys. Okay. Now, something this knife has that was missing on, yes, the button lock Elementum, is that the button lock Elementum, as so many complained, required the button to be pressed to open it as well as to close it. You cannot move it. It is locked in place by the button. And although I'd like to have seen this one with a setup similar to the Cogent, with the flipper tab and a free opening from the closed position, I guess I'm kind of fond of this particular handle and blade combo. So, you know, the Damascus job that Civivi is doing is really impressive. Love those patterns. Even a little bit better on the Cogent. More contrast. So, might be a little bit different finishing work that they're doing. I'm not sure. But look at how they got away, though, with... I mean, you can't have too heavy a detent and have that small a flipper tab, let's face it. But you got a lot of grip on that front surface of that flipper. No problems light switching it. Let's see if we can push button it. Yeah, can push button it too. Check that out. No real problem. Again, only little issue with this one's a little bit of lock stick. I'm going to try using some of the heavyweight KPL on it, see if that assists a little bit. Had to pull back just a little bit on the pivot, give it a little less tension, and still it's centered and it's tight. And there's your centering. There you go. Dead center. How about this one? Yep, dead center on that one too. Very nice. And if you haven't already noticed, a really nice blade to handle ratio. You got a long blade in there for the overall size of the knife. So you get a full 3.5-inch blade in, again, a knife that is well under 8 inches overall. I like the black and black blade and the natural G10. You guys may want to mod this right away and dye it. I kind of like that green translucent look. What can I tell you? Kind of reminds me of the real thing. Jade, that is. Give you another look at the really nice green micarta there with that heavy weave. I think they did a good match of the handle with the Damascus on this one. And by the way, that's the only handle color I'm seeing currently with a Damascus blade. They may change that over time with the success. The jimping on both is just about right. It's not overly aggressive, but you can't really slide on that too easily, so that's a good thing. Even on the black one, usually sometimes they coat over that. This is actually a little grippier than the Damascus version. Yeah, not sure why. But again, deep carry clip, the ones we've been seeing a lot on some of the more recent Civivis. And there you are, seeing double and being cogent. Hope you enjoyed this review. Don't forget to give it a like and subscribe. This old sword Signing out.